What year is it? Give me the year.
1973 on White Sport Coat and Pink Crustacean.
So, I wrote that song in Coconut Grove when I was living with Jerry Jeff Walker, because there was a great folk singer and a great inspiration to all of us down there named Fred Neal, who has written some classic songs, but he was from Coconut Grove, but spent a lot of time in New York in the hip folk singing and came back, but he was like the guru to all of us. And so he wrote Everybody's Talking, and he wrote a lot of Roy Orbison songs, but he was just a great mentor. So Jerry Jeff introduced me to him, and somewhere along the way, either Freddie or Jerry Jeff gave me a couple of Kenneth Patchen poetry books and said, you ought to read this guy because he's really inspiring to kind of get you going on how to really write good lyrics and kind of a little more in-depth stuff. And so I did. And there was a book called The Journey of the Albion Moonlight, and it's not what I would normally read because it's very serious and it's very kind of dark in a way, but kind of like Faulkner was when I was kind of reading him. But I really got into Kenneth Patchen, and I modeled this on him because he died very early, and he had a little bit of success, but not much, until he passed away. So that's kind of where I got the idea to do it. And then also, I was at that stage where I'd been through a lot of rejection in Nashville, and like every record company in town turned me down, and I took all of those memories of that rejection and the Kenneth Patchen stuff, and I wrote a song about a guy who left all his money to his dog. That's what it's really about. So I'm glad I got to play it for my dogs today. And that's where it came from.
Okay, so this song's only been played 10 times in your whole career.
Really?
Why? Because it's unpopular?
Well, you know, the thing of it is, it's not because it's unpopular, because I'm unpopular. I was unpopular for quite a while, so then I got popular. So I don't know why I wouldn't play it, other than the fact that when I normally would play it is when it was quiet and at the end of a show, because it's not something that in our shows, as they took on celebratory things like Mardi Gras, and you're always... When you're writing shows and when you're as a performer you're writing, there's only a couple of simple things. You've got recognition and you got energy, and it's either high energy or low energy, and you kind of set that by different melodies, and so there's two or three things that can make a show go, and ours are a lot of high energy, and you have to drop of course you have to have some times that the audience needs to rest and you want to get some more thoughtful songs in, so that's where Death of Unpopular, always, if I played it, it would probably be at the end as an acoustic song at the end of a show, but I thought I played it more than 10 times. Now 11. Okay.
It's 11. One more question.
What?
Has the meaning of the song changed for you since you wrote it?
I tell you no, because the interesting thing about being quarantined and not being out there running at full speed is to do this and look back on these songs, because I forget I've been doing this for 45 years and I've written a lot of songs, and it's kind of having a little vacation with my former self here to write, to play these songs. And this one I know I could play. Like I said, I played that just right off the top of my head. There's some other ones like Love in the Library, which I'm having to relearn, but I love that song too. They just take me kind of back in my own mind of that time before all this was happening, and I was just writing these songs. This is the way record. We're practicing on live shows again. We're using dogs. Is our first show we played to two people, but right now we're gonna play to two dogs, and this is a captive audience here.
We
have. Let's see. You're gonna like this because you know why? You know why you're gonna like this song? Oh, just quit eating off the floor. You're gonna like this song because in the end, the poet, when he makes some money, he leaves all his money to his dog. You know that? He leaves his money to the dog. And the dog grows old eating steak and bacon.
You'd like that, wouldn't you?
She liked it.